I've only been here 6 weeks, pal. Okay, give me a break.
You probably walked into the Oval Office as president with about as much experience, if not more experience, than any other president who's ever served. More than 3 decades in the Senate, 8 years as vice president. So what is it about the job that surprised you, that even you didn't know? Is Major out of the doghouse?
Yeah, man.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm Drone Tech, and today we're going to look at a propaganda session that's made to look like an actual journalistic interview. Your first clue should be the guy that's giving the interview, George Stephanopoulos, advisor to Bill and Hillary Clinton. Not only does he never disclose this fact to his viewers, but why the hell would you put a guy like that into a national news anchor position in the first place?
An extraordinary apology from George Stephanopoulos, live on Good Morning America. He admitted that he donated $75,000 to the Clinton Foundation and failed to disclose it even as he reported on the controversies surrounding the foundation.
But I should have made additional disclosures on air when we covered the foundation.
We're going to get into the sham of an interview, but first let me tell you about this brand new special offer from Noble Gold. Now, I'm pretty sure we all know that inflation is killing our retirements. Dead. The real rate of inflation? Well, it just won't let you keep up or make a profit. You need a different approach. Precious metals, not Robin Hood or stocks that can crash and leave you losing money. An IRA or a 401k with Noble Gold is the answer. And this month, Noble Gold is gifting a genuine, rare, Carson City minted Morgan Silver dollar with every qualifying IRA or 401k. You can find out more by clicking the link in the description or pinned comment, or by just going to noblegoldinvestments.com. Make sure to tell them Drone Tech Politics sent you.
Now, and a lot of the migrants coming in saying they're coming in because you promised to make things better. It seems to be getting worse by the day. Was it a mistake not to anticipate this surge?
Well, first of all, there was a surge the last 2 years in 19 and 20, there was a surge as well.
This one might be worse.
No, well, it could be, but here's the deal. We're sending back people to, first of all, the idea that Joe Biden said come, because I heard the other day that they're coming because they know I'm a nice guy and I won't do
they're
what
saying
Trump did.
This.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe I was wrong about Stephanopoulos. That was a decent question. Let's see where this goes.
What do you do with an unaccompanied child that comes to the border? Do you repeat what Trump did? Do you repeat what Trump did? Take them from their mothers, move them away, hold them in cells, et cetera? Well, what you have to do is you have to try to get control of the mess that was inherited. And the way to get control of the mess that was inherited, I mean, look, here's what...
Okay, Biden's excuse here is that he inherited the problem from Trump. But didn't Trump inherit the problem from Joe Biden and Barack Obama? Because Trump signed an executive order ending the policy of separating children from the adults that they came with. Which, by the way, might be their parents and might not be. That's partly why they're separated thanks to the Flores decision. Ironically, the Flores decision was put into place because activists claimed that keeping children with their parents was being used as a deterrent. Which is funny because even after the fact, during the Obama years, his administration was accused of keeping kids with the adults as a deterrent. Although the fact remains, Joe Biden and Barack Obama kept kids in so-called cages when they were separated from the adults. The very pictures the media used to attack Trump were in fact from the Obama-Biden years. Something Biden and Biden supporters don't want to talk about are the tens of thousands of kids that were separated from their families due to deportation during his administration.
You're selling your COVID relief package. You're executing the COVID relief package now as well. What's next on your legislative agenda?
If you notice, the criticism of the COVID relief package from my Republican friends is they say it spends too much money and it gives too many tax breaks. All these tax breaks go to the bottom 60% of the population because, in fact, their idea of a tax cut is to give the Trump tax cut where 83% went to the top 1% of the people in America.
You're going
to
be raising those taxes.
Yes. Anybody making more than $400,000 will see a small to a significant tax increase. If you make less than $400,000, you won't see one single penny in additional federal tax.
Wrong.
Again, Stephanopoulos just lets Biden get away with several lies here. For one, he calls Republicans his friends just before accusing them of hating Americans who make under $400,000 a year. Then he claims that Republicans' criticisms are all about COVID relief money, when in fact their objections are to the vast majority of spending in the bill that has nothing to do with COVID relief. In regards to who will receive that tax hike, Biden claims that only people making above $400,000 will see an increase and receive zero pushback from the Democrat Party advisor. Which is odd because the Tax Policy Center put out an analysis showing that, in fact, people making between $50K and $90K a year will see an increase of at least $260, maybe more. I'd say that encompasses most of the middle class, wouldn't you? One of Biden's promises is that he would repeal the Trump tax cut, right? Well, the TPC also found that Trump's tax cut gave middle income earners a tax savings of $900 a year.
Senator Harris said that she wanted to repeal the Trump tax cuts on day one, do away entirely with the law. Now, obviously, the Trump tax cuts significantly lowered the tax rate for lower income earners. In fact, the Tax Policy Center found that some middle income workers saw $900 a year in tax savings. So repealing the Trump tax cuts, full on repeal, that does raise taxes.
So along with coronavirus lockdowns destroying small businesses, Biden will be doing his part to advance the Great Reset. Bottom line here, there's plenty of questions about Biden's answers, but the former Clinton advisor chooses to punt.
Let's talk raw politics here. You didn't get a single Republican vote for tax cuts. How are you going to get a Republican vote for a tax increase?
Well, I may not get but I'll get the Democratic votes for a tax increase. Yep, they're complaining because I'm providing a tax credit for childcare for the poor.
You just say you're not likely to get Republican votes for the tax increase. You're not likely to get Republican votes for H.R. 1, expanding voting rights, or the John Lewis Voting Rights Act. So aren't you going to have to choose? I know you've been reluctant to do away with the filibuster. Aren't you going to have to choose between preserving the filibuster and advancing your agenda?
Yes. Almost it's getting to the point where democracy's having a hard time functioning. I'm not saying this is going to be easy, George. But I do believe there's enough Republicans over time.
They haven't had that epiphany you said you were going to see in the campaign. No.
So here we finally get a critical question from the left about how bad Republicans are for not falling into line. So Biden says at one point, quote, "It's almost getting to the point where democracy is having a hard time functioning." Gee, you think that might have something to do with the former Free Press becoming nothing more than a propaganda organ for one party? I think that about says it all right there, folks. Nothing but softball, lapdog, fake questions with no critical response whatsoever. Biden just said yesterday that we should always assume that women are telling the truth. Why didn't George ask him if that applies to his accusers? Well, the answer's obvious, because that wouldn't make him look good, and George's job is to make Biden look good. That's all for this one. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. If you'd like to support this channel, you can find all those links in the description or pinned comment. Thanks for watching, as always, and I'll see you all next time.